Men als je gaat spelen een melodie.
My music is not jazz. You know, it's very difficult to categorize. Very difficult category. My music. It's not mainstream jazz. It's not experimental. It's really purely oriental. Oh, not oriental. Original. Sorry about okay. Oriental. But original. Yeah.
Just listening in while she composes on Cubase, yeah. And she sends me the basic files, and then I just say my tuppence worth. Because if you're composing by yourself and nobody gives you a tuppence worth back, then you don't really get much to bounce off.
Right.
It's
quite technical then, to some degree.
Yeah. I mean, I don't read music, but obviously I can hear it.
Yeah.
And I've got very similar musical tastes, I suppose.
Right.
Also, I've been doing films as a musician around Japan. I've just been taking little snapshots, you know, just literally out of train windows and just people walking around and sort of montage those. I've got quite a few films up on YouTube.
Yeah.
I met Taiko about 7-8 years ago, maybe. I actually can't remember. I think she phoned me up, because she was a Japanese pianist and I was playing the Japanese flute, so she was interested to meet somebody playing a Japanese traditional instrument.
That's quite unusual.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I used to live in Japan and I studied it there. I was a flute player and one day, a very long time ago, somebody played me some recordings of this flute and I was completely knocked out by it. I thought, I became slightly obsessed with it and I thought that's the flute I really want to learn to play. So I ended up living there for a while and having lessons with a teacher.
hopefully not just because of the flute.
Yeah, well, that was...
That was the main reason to be there.
I gradually became obsessed with everything about Japan, the history and the culture. But yeah, it kind of started... when I heard Japanese traditional music, I found it extremely appealing, but also very hard to understand what on earth was going on. But after years of Western classical music, it was like somebody had kind of flung open the window, and there was sort of fresh air coming in. And I was really intrigued because I didn't understand it at all. But
it's a long learning process, isn't it?
Yeah. It's maybe not as bad as Indian music, where there's a real lifetime commitment kind of thing. Obviously, with any instrument, you can make a lifetime commitment. But I think in India, the teachers like to really rub that in. Whereas I found Japanese traditional musicians were surprisingly open to somebody coming from outside. I mean, they thought I was slightly mad for wanting to study this, but once you start doing it alongside them, they were extremely generous and open about the whole thing. So that was great.
Yes, my musical influence is classical music, for example, Bach, Stravinsky, Takemitsu, and American jazz is also in my influence. For example, Miles Davis, Thelonious Monk. Yes, that's right. So I played with different musicians from different countries. Yes, so quite interesting experience being in London, because London is very cosmopolitan. That we are going to record in December as very interesting musicians and very great musicians, in Clive Bell, shakuhachi player, who is going to play with me today, and also do you know shakuhachi, Japanese bamboo flute? That's very, very interesting sound, very nice sound. And then Camilo Tirado, who play tabla, and also different percussion. And also we got very interesting things. We got Tsugaru Shamisen player, Japanese Hibiki. Yes, he's going to play two tunes.